How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop over here on the Lance lathe. And what I have in here is one of these. I think Robin Renzetti will know what this is. And a few others. John Saunders would know what this is. This is a Tormach machinable tool holder, whatever you want it. This part's hardened up here, and this part's been annealed, and so it's machinable. And what I've been asked to do is, could I make a set of dovetail cutters so they'll just go right in a Tormach? So we're gonna, the plan is here, I'm gonna make a large one and a small one out of a couple of these. Now, it's not gonna have a super long shank on it because it's only about 40 millimeters here, about an inch and three quarters or so. 40 millimeters, yeah, about an inch and a quarter, something like that. So yeah, about, well, inch and 5/8. I have an inch and 5/8, and these things are an inch and a half in diameter. So I've got it in the 6-jaw. I was gonna do a collet, but I figure I could probably get it even better if I just do it in the 6-jaw, because this is an adjustable chuck. So I've got it dialed in here, and we're looking at less than barely see the needle even move. So less than a half a thousandth for sure on there. So it's almost like measuring the surface roughness. So it's probably the best I'm going to get right there. And we're going to machine that into a dovetail cutter. I think that's pretty good. So what the plan's going to be is I'm going to turn this down to the outside diameter of the head of the cutter. And then I'll come in and have to cut down the shank portion. And then probably the last part would be the angle. So we have 266 thousandths come off of it. Well, cuts nice. Cuts real nice. Now I'm turning at 864 RPM. 40,000 depth of cut, so 80 thousandths on the diameter right there. And I'll have to check the feed. Probably about six or eight, maybe. Somewhere there. But we'll just go right up to the shiny part, I think. We're going to do 50 thousandths here. Same feed. pretty good, 1.231, so that's good. It's a little bit warm, and so I'll shrink down a little bit, that'll be just fine. I painted it red for Christmas. A little hard to see, but I scribed a line around it right there, and that's 600 thousandths from the end. That'll give me room to cut in there for the angle, right? The 30 degree angle we need to put on there. We'll cut the rest down to 5/8. Ask me why 5/8. Well, 5/8 is just enough to give you full insert edge on this angle. That's why 5/8, and it gives you just enough clearance. That's a really, it's kind of the optimum shank size, and it's plenty heavy enough for all the vibration and everything. Changed over to a DNMG to get in there, and I have a 30 degree angle on there now, so I know about where I'm gonna be. We're getting down there, we're almost there, so we're about the smallest part right where I'm at, about 3/4 of an inch. Way that's a practice cut. If I have to make a finished cut at 10 thousandths, I think that'll be just fine, it looks like. A little small carbide radius tool here. I'm gonna put a radius in this end here. I really like this tool. It's a notch insert type tool, but it has, so it has two ends and nice little radius on there, and it's great for reaching in and doing things like that. I did a little buff up on it, and I think we're good. It's ready to come out. This came out a lot better than I thought it was going to come out. That's what it started with. Now we'll turn this one into a small one. Gonna be the same process. There, popped it out. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. I'm gonna engrave my logo on the end. It's still black from the original finish, whatever they put on there. Well, I failed to film the milling part of it, but the milling part is the same as all the other milling parts as far as dovetail cutters go. I did film the turning. So hey, I got that part done. But here's the finished products. Half-inch shank, 5/8 shank, all one piece, turned from the Tormach machinable tool holder, they call it, a blank tool holder. These were bought from Little Machine Shop, part number 2698, and then I turned them into a dovetail cutter. This is going to Scott over in Hawaii. Hope he likes them. I think they came out really, really nice. Very, very good idea, I think, for a CNC machine at least. You know, it's already set, ready to go. It's pretty cool. It was his idea, wasn't mine. And he sent me the tool holders, and we got it done for him. I think that's a cool idea. Even engraved them. I engraved them on the end and everything, just like the other, like all the other dovetail cutters I make, right? These do take a bit of extra works. If anybody else wants something like this, let me know and I'll give you a price on it. So thank you, and thank you, Scott.